here's another lesson with place value. First, you have to be able to read numbers, right? You need to be able to read them correctly. Then, if you can do that, you can write them in word form and at least be able to recognize them in word form, even if you can't spell them correctly. Now, after you are able to write them in word form, then you learn how to do expanded form. And then now you're ready for some fun stuff. We will compare using symbols. Equal to, greater than, and less than symbols. You've seen these symbols before. Now, let's look at using these symbols and placing these in the bubbles to compare these two forms. Now look, the first one, example number one, you have word form and then standard form. Boys and girls, it's very important that you don't just guess at this, but you actually try to write down what you see from the word form in standard form so that you can compare standard form to standard form. Let's look at the first one. 95,405. Well, if you can take the standard form and write it in word form, you should be able to do it backwards too. All right, so let's write 95,000. 95,405. 405. Now, we can compare this number to this number. Always when comparing digits, start with the greatest value. Why would you start with the greatest value? Well, let's take a look. What if you started with this one and this one? The 5, you might say, is larger than a 0, and you would be correct. But is this number greater than this number? I don't think so. So let's look. So start at the greatest value first. Let's compare 9 and 9. They're the same. Let's continue to the next digit. 5 and 5, they're the same. Continue. 4 and 4, the same, right? Let's go to this digit, which is the tens place. 0 and 5. Now wait a second. 0 and 5 are different. 5 is greater than 0. $50 is greater than $0, right? So, and especially if we're talking about money, that's a big deal. So, here's where we would stop and compare the tens place. Not the ones place. Although 5 is greater than 0, 50 is greater than 0. So, in this case, this number is greater than this number. You probably learned this in way back in first and second grade, that the alligator eats the big number. And you can imagine this symbol as an alligator with teeth gobbling up the big number. I don't care how you remember it. Just remember that this symbol always is going to open up to the greatest value. All right, let's look at the next example. Here's a number that has been expanded, right? And we're comparing it to a number that is in standard form. We have to write this back in standard form to be able to compare it to this number in standard form. All right, so let's rewrite this number and let's pull it back down to a number that where we can compare the two numbers. 9 times 10,000. That would be a 9 in the what place? In the 10,000's place, right? So we've got to remember that this is going to be in the 10,000's digit. 3 times 1,000 is 3,000. So the 3 is going to be in the 1,000's place. Now, because I just said 1,000, let me put my comma here. And let me make sure that so far what I have matches this. 93 1,000. That sounds like what I'm looking for. 90. And this is 3,000, right? So 93,000. Now, let's continue. 2 in the hundreds place. 2 times 100 is 2. 2 in the hundreds place. And an 8 in the tens place. And a 5 in the ones place. Now, here is our standard form number. This can be compared to this number. Let's start at the greatest value. 9 is the same. Move to the next one. 3 and 2. Which one's larger? This one, right? So, 92,385. It sounds a lot the same, doesn't it? And that's how you'll have with problems, is you'll have numbers that are slightly mixed up, but you have to start at the greatest value. So 93,000 is larger. This way, your equality is going to eat the big number, which is 93,285, which is the easiest one because we don't have to change it back. It's already in standard form. If you will start with the greatest value, it will be a breeze. 3 is the same. 5, 8, 4, 7, all the way to the last digit. You would know it. We're comparing this one and this one. 3 is greater, isn't it? So this is the way that we will draw the symbol. What would happen, though, if we had a 3 right here? What if the 3 was right here in place of that 2? Would the symbol change? Yes, it would, wouldn't it? We would have to change this symbol. Now the symbol would look like this because the numbers would be equal, right? Okay, so do you feel smarter? I bet you are. Place value can be a lot of fun. You will get the hang of it. Just try.